Today we're going to do the layout for our shorts, our boxer shorts for grade 8. So we've got our pattern here, and we have the layout checklist that's in our booklet, our grade 8 booklet. We're going to follow this and check off each of the steps as we go through for success in our layout. And then I will mark each student's layout, and this layout checklist should go into the textiles inbox. But first, let's follow along with what it says to do here. The first thing that we need to do is to take our fabric and to fold it fashion fabric together. When we folded it fashion fabric together for our random print fabric, we're going to make sure the selvages are matching the two raw edges, even though for this flannelette they're not perfectly matched. We're going to try to get them as close as possible, like this, and opposite that should be a fold in the fabric at the bottom. Closest to me is the fold. I'm going to pin the selvages together, and I'm going to place the pins parallel to the selvage. That way they won't interfere with the laying out of the pattern. And I'm going to place the pins about every hand width along the way. Make sure, try your best to keep your selvages right together like that. Then on this end, I'll batch them as well. This helps me keep the weft and the warp threads on the grain or at right angles. So the fabric is considered on the grain and it will be able to, the garment will hang properly. Now I'm going to place my pattern on here. And I'm going to bring it close to this folded edge and check at the top to make sure that I've been able to get all of the pattern on all the fabric. So I have two layers at the top here. I'm going to put the pin in one end of the arrow. Because this was a long pair of pants, the other end of the arrow is on the pant leg. But we cut it off here because we're making view E. This is the cutting line for view E. So here's one end of the arrow, and we'll use the other end of this straight line to check to see that the pattern is laid on the grain. I'm going to measure from this arrow to the selvage here, and I'm going to do the same thing at the bottom of the arrow to make sure that the pattern is parallel, this arrow is parallel to the selvage. So if it's not quite, then all I do is just pivot on this and bring it so that the edge of my tape measure is on the arrow and the same distance is at the selvage. So if this was 12 at the top, it would need to be 12 at the bottom. Or if it was 20 at the top of the arrow, it would need to be 20 at the bottom of the arrow. So I have checked mine. Here it's 55.5, and down here it's 55.5 again. And I'm going to put my pin in at a right angle here. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my pattern, I'm going to smooth it out, and I'm going to pin from the inside to the outside of the corner of the pattern. So it's at a 45 degree angle. This holds this corner in nice and tight. Now, we happen to have 6 points on this pattern, the crotch, the bottom of this part, the hem, smooth it out over here, and over here. Here we go. Now that we've done that, we're going to take some pins, and we're going to place them about every hand width all the way around the outside of the garment. So go down and then back up. So I want to see both ends of this pin, so the ball end and the pointed end here. And we want to place these about every hand width around the outside of this garment. Make sure when you come to the curve that you get a pin right in the curve, because when we go to cut on the curve, we want to make sure that it's held down. if you were doing this at home, you would need to be take great care that whatever was underneath here wasn't mm-hmm. getting scratched when you were doing placing your pins. You could get a special cutting board that you can buy at a textile store so that you're not damaging a nice dining room table. All right, now we've got this pattern nice and secure onto the fabric. We're going to take our shears and we're going to cut out around the pattern. These shears in the classroom, the ones with the stars that are tied onto the handles, are the best shears for cutting out. Make sure when you go to cut out that you have one hand on the pattern and one hand on the good shears, and you're cutting towards the garment. Nice long cuts help make a nice straight line. When you come to a notch, just cut it out. And then carry on. I don't want to try to turn and cut this way. It would be inaccurate. So I will turn my body to the side and cut the curve gently around.
Kristen Sibel, you're wanted by the office, please. Kristen Sibel.
These are two notches together, so I'll cut them together. Out, across, and back in. Like symbols to me. They tell me things. Like these two notches will identify the center front seam. Over here I have three notches. That identifies the center back seam when I'm making the garment. Place your hand beyond the pattern to keep the garment from moving. Make sure that your garment is flat, that there's nothing underneath here that can get accidentally cut. Now this pattern has a little bit, there we go. Okay, I've checked my pattern pins already, but I need to be very careful that none of them come through the cutting line. If I was coming up to that and accidentally cut with my good fabric shears, there's a good chance I could make a nick in the steel here. So I need to make sure that the pins do not extend beyond the cutting line. Take a check. We don't want to damage our good shears. Good shears can last you a very long time. I'm going to take these pins out and I'm going to place them back in my magnet to hold my pins so that I can fold this up. This bit here I'm probably not going to use, so I'm going to just fold it, and that can be for the garbage can. I'll take these ones out of here as well, and I'm going to finish this. Sometimes when it's skinny like this, I find that if I can hold the fabric at the bottom here, I can cut this line straighter. Just be very careful that you don't allow the pins to cross the cutting line here and damage the best shears we have. This will be for my garbage. Over here, I'm going to cut myself a piece for my sample seam. So I'm going to look here and I'm going to say, okay, I will cut it 20 centimeters. I'm just wanting you to look at this and to try. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just to practice our straight cutting. This is a good amount across here, so I'm pretty happy at that. Usually I like it about 15. And so I can use this for my sample seam. I just like to square it up. This piece I'll use for practice stitching. These little bits are not much. I'm going to put that to the side. Over here, We can use this fabric to make a little pillow if we like, but most importantly, remember what I said about needing some fabric at the start of sewing to practice stitching. So I would like to cut a couple of pieces here so I'm ready to go. Whenever I start a new project, I want to have some things to start sewing with. And I always need to make sure that when I practice on my machine, I fold this fabric in half so I have two layers to practice stitch on. So I will put those together so I'm ready to start my machine. I'll put this aside for when I'm ready to decide what to do with this. This will be for my sample seam that I have to do. This is for the garbage can. Over here, now that I'm finished, I want to take all the pins out except for the two that are on the straight of the grain. So the rest of these pins can go back into your pin box or however you're storing them. And that way you don't have to get poked in your hand when you start sewing.
Mr. Francis, please phone the office. Mr. Francis.
Now, I'm going to fold my garment and place it in my sewing box so that I'll be ready for the next day, along with this extra fabric that I have. All of this goes in my sewing box.